hate it. I don't like the fake handshake, snake Tennessee. You an enemy. All them lies you telling, I can't let that be the end of me. No, no. Probably cause your girl feeling me. It's a flag on the play, all these catching penalties. Look, I don't like your energy. I don't like the fake handshake, snake Tennessee. Let's go. Don't make me jog your memory. I did upgrade, you then upgraded the world, how they forgetting me. Please make it make some sense to me. How you talking about the greatest, still ain't greatest, mention me. Them bands, I want the symphony.
Tonight, from AT&T Stadium, here now to get us started is Logan Cook, and we are underway from AT&T Stadium. And this will go as a touchback, and they will begin things at the 25. Now we'll see what the right arm of Dak Prescott has in store as the Dallas Cowboys offense sets up shop.
And how about the toughness of Dak Prescott? We see it all the time on the field. And remember when he had that serious ankle injury, would he return to form? Boy, did he ever. And he was better than ever, and that's great for the NFL. Terrific resilience, playing at a high level, capable of winning a championship with his arm and his legs.
So the drive's going to start with Pollard, and he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Give him 10 there, good enough for a Cowboy first down. But one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there, and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense, because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
How about this throw right here? Had to throw it to the left sideline, and you know the timing's got to be correct on this one. Ball's got to be right where it needs to be, and it was. That's because he had great arm strength on that one, able to drive the football. Quarterbacks love it when they can show off their arms.
And he's going to be taken down right at the 40-yard line. On second down, it's Pollard. And he's got room. And an excellent job of finding the opening as he's got this now all the way down to the 22. 17 yards on the play there, and the Cowboys have a first down. You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards.
A lot of precision being shown on this opening drive. They've been methodical, they've been crisp, and as a reward, they're going to be set up with an early first and goal.
Now Prescott. Eluding the pressure right. And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. Josh Allen coming in from that outside linebacker spot, and he buries him for a loss of 7.
Well, there's still time to rectify this situation, because the silver lining, they took a sack on first and goal. But that close to the goal line, it still definitely hurts.
After the sack on first down, Prescott throwing the out route and complete. It's Burgess. That time the completion goes for 4 yards, and we're set up with a third and goal. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, and now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this four down territory? Might he go for it?
You know, last week I remember asking you, what would an offensive coordinator be looking for week two of the preseason? Now we're in week three. Defensive coordinator-wise, what's he looking at?
For the most part in preseason, you're playing pretty basic stuff, pretty vanilla defenses. You're looking for guys that play with abandon, that just go out and make plays, that kind of let their athletic ability take over in order for you to notice them.
And all in all, a pretty decent opening drive, Charles. Pretty balanced. They had the passing game going and the rushing attack, too.
I would think they have to be happy with that start, because you get your ground game going, which means your offensive line and your runners are pretty happy. And then you get your aerial attack going as well, so your quarterback and receivers have smiles on their faces. Now both up to speed, awaiting their next possessions for this game. They can't wait to get started again.
So here's the first drive now for the Jags. They're led by the number one overall pick in the 2021 draft, Trevor Lawrence.
The word is potential, potential, potential. Think about this guy from the time he was in high school, one of the top prospects going to college, coming out of college, mentioned as a generational type quarterback. He looks the part. Tall, big arm, surveys the field, and can take off and run when under duress.
Now ETN to start the drive. And he's not going anywhere to start the night. They stop him at the line of scrimmage. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. The slot man in motion right. On second down, ETN once more. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
There, the Cowboys here on third down, bringing in an extra defensive back. Jones now in motion left. From the gun, it's Lawrence. He'll get this one complete to Zay Jones. And he will have a Jaguars first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. When you give up points on the opening drive, in this case a field goal, you'd hate to go three and out. They avoid that.
They do, and it's also walking that fine line mentally, too, as a coach, isn't it? Because you want to emphasize to your team exactly what you said. All right, we gave up a field goal. Let's go back and at least equal that, guys. But if we don't, you don't want them to feel like it's the end of the world, either. Nice that they were able to pick up the first down there, help them relax a little bit.
So that run play nullified by the holding call on the tight end.
Yeah, I just think he needs to get off the ball a lot quicker and get into the block a little bit more effectively. Then he doesn't have to reach and grab and try and hold on.
In motion left goes Jones. Here's Lawrence to throw. And his throw here is incomplete.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground, incomplete.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. Throwing on second and long. Lawrence. And this one into the hands of Ingram downfield. Touchdown, Jaguars! Evan Ingram, 62 yards. And the Jaguars have answered that early field goal to take a first quarter lead. When they drew that up, I don't think they envisioned it ending in a house call. But he got it and took it all the way home.
Really impressive run after the catch, wasn't it? That was really special by him. But let's face it, in today's NFL, Those tight ends are often former wide receivers or maybe even sometimes bigger running backs. They just put them in a position to get a great matchup and make plays like that.
Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And that makes it a 7-3 lead. After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. This taken in at the goal line. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Let's go! Second drive forthcoming here for the Dallas Cowboys. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put six on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now Prescott. Over the middle, complete. That's Ferguson. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 13 yards on his first catch. It's a first down as well. After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. They'll go with Pollard here on first down. And he'll grab a gain of 5 out of this up to the 41-yard line.
Nice satisfying run on first down for the offense, picking up 5, which means defensively, the thought process is entirely different. You don't want to panic, but at the same time, you're saying to each other, we've got to tighten this down. We can't give up gains like that.
Play action now, Prescott. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
Much like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time, wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately, had an alert teammate who was able to get it.
So possession still theirs, but now they face a third down. Prescott now, and this is going to be incomplete. These offensive starters still out there in the second quarter. You would think the plans for them to at least play into the third quarter, if not all the way through it.
Yeah, it might go by feel. If they have a really good first drive to start the third quarter, they might pull them after that. If not, might leave them out there a little bit longer, but I'll guarantee this, they'll be gone by the start of the fourth quarter.
There we go. It's a 50-yard punt, 6 yards on the return. And it'll be Jaguar football as they take over deep in their own territory. Jones now in motion left. They go play action now. Lawrence. He'll air this one out for Kirk. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down.
A deep ball down that right sideline, and he made sure that he put it where either his guy was going to catch it or no one was.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. The gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down, because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
On third down, Lawrence. Man open, that's Calvin Ridley. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. His first catch there, good for 10 yards and a first down. Ready, Slot man moves right. On first and 10, it's Lawrence. Man open here is Jones. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
Charles, to move the chains that time, they had to complete it into double coverage, and they got it done.
And it's never easy overcoming multiple defenders, but he sure made it look simple. Found the right spot to exploit and won his one-on-two matchup.
He'll buy some time right. And that is caught. It's Ridley. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays.
Mike McCarthy, pretty decisive. He brings out that red challenge flag. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, it certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Well, here's the call.
Let's go, boys. Let's go.
After review of the play. So the challenge there does not go their way. This will indeed remain a completed pass. The slot man in motion right. On first and 10, it's ETN. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4. In motion right is Jones. On second down at 4, Lawrence. He's got a man. It's his fullback. And they'll work this down inside the 30.
And the big guy catches the ball out of the backfield, and oftentimes it's quite a surprise to the guys playing defense because not ordinarily thought as a pass catcher, it often works when they decide to dial it up.
They'll run with ETN. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 10 yards there, good enough for a Jags first down. 2 minutes to play in this first half, 7-3, our score. So here's a first and 10 now, down inside the 20. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. They'll find his tight end, that's Waller. And out of bounds all the way down at the 3. Another nice gain, 16 yards there and a first down again.
Just picking up yardage in bunches here these last few plays. They have moved right down the field, and just like that, they're going to be set up with a first and goal.
And he'll get him a bit closer as he's down to the 2-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal.
Good work there, holding him out on first down. And this is going to be a battle down here on the goal line. Can they hold their ground for 2, maybe even 3 more plays?
One more time with ETN. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. This Cowboy defense trying to hold him out of the end zone. They've run it to 3rd and goal.
They'll try to run with ETN. And this time he is in. A touchdown run there from a yard out. And the Jags will extend their lead in the final minute of the half. Badgley on for the extra point. And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. That one in the books as a 12-play drive. And it was capped off by a Travis Etienne touchdown run. After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he won't quite make it to the 25. And the Cowboys going to go on offense one final time in this first half. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Give them a gain of 5 on the completion, and it'll be second down. So we've reached halftime here with the visiting Jaguars out on top as we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
All right, Brandon, thank you very much. Week 3 of the preseason is here. Everyone wrapping up their exhibitions.
Looks like somebody's ready to begin the regular season, skipping over halftime here in the final game of the preseason. Third quarter, here we go. Our starters likely to be out there for the third quarter as we get back underway in this second half. No run back here to begin the half, and we will start at the 25-yard line. Out come the Jaguars now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. This offense set to begin the third quarter, and Charles, if they had a checklist of things they wanted to accomplish in the first half, certainly at the top of that list would be having the lead, and they've got that here.
That's always the most important box to check, isn't it? But also, they've had some success in their passing game, so probably an empty box establishing the run. They're on pace for fewer than 100 yards in this one. So now they want to make sure that they get that going so they truly have a control in this ball game and down the stretch being able to be balanced, either throw it or run it, and try and win this ball game.
And he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32.
But when you go from second to four to third and three, that just tells you who won that battle on the last play, huh?
Yeah, first round went to the offense, second round the defense. Slot man moves right. On third down, here's ETN. And I don't think he got there, no. He's short by maybe a foot, maybe. Call it fourth and inches. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Room here to run. And he will finally be taken out of bounds. Wow, first and goal, and defensively, all they can do is shake their heads. Not only did they allow the conversion, but a big play as well. ETN will score. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Well, nothing fancy there, Charles. You had three tight ends on the field. They were going to run the football. The defense knew it, but the defense couldn't stop it.
And I haven't met an offensive line yet that doesn't get more satisfaction out of running the football into the end zone than pass protecting. They had determination on their side, and they got it done.
After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. This fielded right at the goal line. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. The Cowboys offense now, they head out for their first possession of the second half. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 27. On play action, they'll throw. He's got a man complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. Give him 32 on the play.
Prescott. He's got his man. It's Gallup. And he'll be taken down at about the 22-yard line. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. There's Prescott. Buying time to his left. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down.
Oh, partner, just a second earlier, and they might have had him because they certainly thought they were going to close in and drop him behind the line of scrimmage, but he had just enough time to dodge the pressure, and he ends up getting yardage before being stopped.
Down to the 6-yard line on a pickup of 6 as he gets halfway to the goal line.
You know what I like about that play? He didn't try to do too much on first down. He took what the defense gave him, put together a solid gain to bring up second and manageable. Now they have a couple of plays to pick up just a few yards and a new set of downs.
And the Cowboys are going to have a first and goal as some good running there gets him down to about the 2-yard line, knocking on the door. Now here's Pollard, and he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Tony Pollard taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Cowboys get a bit closer. Extra point splits the uprights, and it makes the score 21-10. That time a 6-play drive, and it's culminated by a 2-yard touchdown run. Now Jamal Agnew from his end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. Their lead down to 2 scores after the touchdown a moment ago as they start with a 1st and 10. They'll start on the ground, ETN. And he'll get this just across the 25-yard line. The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. In motion left goes Jones. To throw on 2nd and 6, Lawrence. He completes it to Ridley. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. ETN up the middle, and he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick, he's been decisive, and he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
From just shy of midfield, Lawrence. Lawrence hit and the ball is free. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And now off to the races down the right side. And this is going to be brought back for a fumble return touchdown by the Cowboys.
So that's about as fortuitous of a bounce as you're going to find as it's scooped up and taken in for the touchdown.
And I love how you use the word fortuitous there, because as that popped up, he just happened to be in the right place.
And now the pressure gets there, and he goes down. So he couldn't get rid of the football, and that deficit stays right where it is. They had the big play on the fumble return. They were looking for the 1-2 punch, but they couldn't get that 2-point conversion.
And I have to wonder, were they scheduled to go ahead and kick the extra point? But after a play like that, you talk about the 1-2 punch, right? It's a momentum play. Go for 2 and really try to capitalize, and that's what they attempted.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They'll be looking to make amends for the events of a moment ago. A fumble return for 6 points.
You absolutely have to protect the football. That's got to be priority number one, because margin for error is starting to slip away. Now it's down to a 1-score game.
And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's 2nd down.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move,
Defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of him, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
And he will be taken down, but a big pickup there on what's going to be the final play of the third quarter. They'll bring a receiver in motion left. And now the first throw for the backup quarterback. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. He's got room at the 30. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. That one good for 37 yards.
I think this defense was still trying to recover from that last play, so you wonder if they were ready for this one. You have to imagine their defensive coaches are yelling at them to get focus, because if they don't, more plays like that will result in giving up points.
On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And he'll get them inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
If you can keep getting gains like that, Charles, with the lead here in the fourth quarter, I mean, keep running it, right?
No doubt about it, but what the offense coordinator has to do is understand they're going to continue to stack the line of scrimmage. What runs do you have in your arsenal that'll work against a stacked box and continue to move the ball?
And he's going to be marked down just outside the 10. The Jaguars on third down. They've been near perfect, 4 for 5 to this point. They're looking at 3rd in the nose of the football. They'll try and run for the first with Edwards. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on 3rd. How about this offensive line? They're really starting to establish themselves, take over this game.
And before the series began, I know exactly what was said in the defensive huddle. Guys, we got to get no less than a 3 and out. Let's get off the field. Instead, they can't find any traction towards doing that. Right now, they're just getting muscled all over the field and getting pushed down it.
And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the 5 down to the 3.
This is where coaches have to have spent a lot of time going over situations with their players, because him getting tackled there is not the worst thing in the world. You're going to run more plays, right? Clock's going to go. But his thought process is getting into the end zone. It's counterintuitive for him to actually go down in this spot.
Yeah, but like you say, you don't want to get in the end zone too early here.
No, not at all, because you may leave an opening that could come back and get you.
A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, 3rd and goal. Back to throw, Freeman. And that is caught. Touchdown, Jacksonville. J.J. Arcega-Whiteside from 3 yards out. And the Jaguars get an important score there to extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And it gives his guys a 12-point advantage. After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. Taken at the goal line. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further, as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. The Cowboys about set to take over on offense. Well, that last touchdown we just saw, what an important one. Now it's back to a 2-score deficit for this crew as they take the field here, and they are in desperate need of finding the end zone. And throwing here to start the drive as they connect left side. And they're able to get this one across the 35. From all the way up at the 38 now after a good start to the drive. Looking to throw. Prescott. Dancing to his left. He finds his man complete. That's Burgess. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Right back to him for 10 more and a first. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
And oh, that nearly their first pick of the game, but it falls down to the ground incomplete. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. They'll throw again. Prescott. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Graves. That'll leave him with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset.
They'll come to the line needing only 2 yards to gain the first here.
Prescott on 3rd and 2. He finds his man complete. It's Graves. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 31-yard line. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. It's Devin Lloyd with a pick, and the Jags are going to get this back to their own 34-yard line.
Well, we knew this was going to be a tall order anyway, down 2 scores with this little time remaining, but that interception puts an end to any hopes that they had.
All right, partner, work with me here because obviously scoring a touchdown, getting the onside kick, then going down, scoring again. Well, that's asking a lot, isn't it? And that's really not a great expectation to begin with. I think they'll look back on this game and see what got them in this spot in the first place and say to themselves, we really gave this game away.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
From the 34, they'll come to the line on 2nd and 10. A give for Edwards running right, and he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll get it with just under 90 seconds remaining. And on 3rd down, the Cowboys bring in an extra defensive back. They'll send a receiver in motion to the left. To throw on 3rd down, Freeman. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up 4th down. Here's Logan Cook now as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. Fielded at the 20. They call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a 1st and 10. So Dak Prescott in the offense. Down by 12. 1:17 remains. You can't say the preseason isn't interesting. This has been great as they come up 1st and 10. Prescott. Throw left side complete. That's Burgess. And he'll be out of bounds at the 25-yard line.
Now, worth reminding at this point, no overtime in the preseason. But that may not come into play here in a 2-score game late.
The throw over the middle taken in. 7 yards there and a 1st down. And we've reached the 1-minute mark in this game. Now Prescott. He finds his man complete. It's Graves. The Cowboys looking to get going again in a hurry. Now Dak. He's going to let it fly. And a penalty flag comes in as that one winds up incomplete. But the contact is going to move the ball well downfield.
Well, there were about 70,000 that were quickly calling for that flag. It comes out there for pass interference.
And what do you think, partner? A little sarcasm in that cheering from this crowd here tonight. What they're hoping now is to build a little momentum off of it and give them a more genuine reason to cheer down the road.
He finds his man complete. That's Graves. The Cowboys going to use their 2nd timeout now as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this 4th quarter. Here's Dak. Got his tight end. That's complete. It's Porter. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. Now the offense will burn their 3rd and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. to throw, Prescott.
And this is caught, so it's a late touchdown, but maybe too late. Still a little time left on the clock, however. Point after here coming up. And this is back to a five-point game. A drive that time of six plays. So looking at this situation, you should have time for the onside kick and then at least one play. And this is going to be recovered by the Jaguars. And that should just about do it. They had to go for it with no timeouts remaining, though, now. This one's as good as over.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best, did everything they could to try and get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try it. It was their only option. And now this game is done. Just take it, kneel, and call it a day.
They'll roll him out right. Got a man. It's caught at the six-yard line. And he's across for the late touchdown. And in the final seconds, that one should just about put a capper on this game.
He put quite a bit of air underneath that touchdown pass. Of course, we knew that he had the strong arm.
That part was easy. You could see that throughout his college career. But what you want to know about a rookie is, when the pressure's on, can you throw with touch? He just did right there. And boy, it was pretty.
Here's Badgley now to try to add the PAT.
And he's been a busy man. 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Those are the kind of drives they like on offense, from the coordinator to the quarterback, the line, everybody. One play drive and into the end zone for 6. And the Cowboys are able to recover. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30.
Scoring game, Charles, than we typically see in the National Football League, but fun to watch these offenses. They were really clicking. It seemed like everything that they dialed up worked.
Yeah, it certainly was fun to watch from our perspective. How'd you like to be those defensive coaches, though? That wasn't a blast for them at all. And let's face it, they all game plan, they all scout, they all think they're prepared, but executing and stopping teams, that's another matter entirely.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gunn. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we say good night from AT&T Stadium.